I was driving home from work late the other night. Must have been a little after two. The night was clear and I was hitting green lights. Once I get home, I'm gonna have an ice cold brew. Now I was doing about 60 kilometers an hour, steering my car towards my habitat. Little did I know, a little further up the road, crossing the street, was this little kitty cat. Now, I guess that cat didn't see my Chevy. Headlights on. But by the time I saw them twinkly little eyes, all I knew that that cat was gone. So why did that feline take to running? You know, it just stared at my grill instead. It didn't run to the left, it didn't run to the right, so I rolled down my window and shouted, "Cat! Duck your fucking head!" But I don't think he heard me. 'Cause his head went on the front bumper. I heard the scream. The neck went, the pant legs went, and the fan belt went to his tail. I heard the rib cage go on the oil pan, and various and sundry parts under my Chevrolet. He went around my back tire, and on the road he lay. Now I've seen some really sad, depressing things in my life, but the saddest, most depressing thing I've ever seen to this day was it looking in my rear view mirror and seeing that poor cat try to walk away. He's trying to walk. Well, I said to myself, I pulled over, "You gotta save that puss. You gotta back your car up to the scene of the crime before it gets run over by the next Jane Street bus." Well, I backed up to the scene of the crime. Oh my God, this cat needs more than a veterinarian's med. The poor thing was so lame, I don't think his life would ever be the same. So I drove over him a second time instead. His head went on the front bumper. I heard him scream. His neck went, the back legs went, and the back span went to his tail. I heard the rib cage go on the oil pan, and various and sundry parts under my Chevrolet. He went, kapunk, kapunk, around.